Welcome everyone to another Star Wars The Old Republic video, and in this video we're going to be talking about a few ways in which you can actually glitch out the game and explore some areas that you probably haven't seen before. Because you might not know that there's actually a world outside of what you can kind of normally access in the MMO, and there's been certain areas that have been created or that are at least there that you can kind of get to and doesn't really serve you any purpose aside from maybe having a new area to just kind of run around in, some new scenery to look at, as well as maybe a cool place to host a duel or a party or something like that. But in any case, you decide what to do with it. I'm just here to show you how to access it. A lot of these are going to involve strongholds, and a couple are going to involve the fleet as well. So we'll start with some of the stronghold stuff, and there's actually a logout method you can use to try to access some areas you might not normally be able to access. Now, the method I'm going to show you here works on both Jomon Kaas and Coruscant, can also be used on Manaan, and they basically allow you to explore different areas. So the way the logout method works is when you jump off an area like a balcony or something, like on Jomon Kaas or Coruscant, and if you just have the logout kind of menu ready, and the second you jump off, right before you're about to die, just log out of the game. And then when you log back into the game, you will have actually fallen the full height of the jump. This will allow you to explore the bottom that you normally wouldn't have access to. So this allows for you to explore a really cool area in Jomon Kaas, because the Jomon Kaas fall is a lot longer than the Coruscant one, for example. And this gives you a really cool area of Jomon Kaas to explore. It's very spacious and open, not much to see, very similar to what you would probably see on Jomon Kaas the planet. But as you guys can see up there, you can still see the balcony and everything, as well as it just allows you a very spacious area, as I was saying earlier, to maybe if you wanted to host a party or a duel or something like that, it's a very unique area to do something in. The very same thing can be done on Coruscant, but Coruscant the Fall is actually a lot smaller because there's a whole bunch of these kind of mini buildings that have been put here. So what you can actually do is keep using the logout method to fall even, you know, further down, and that will allow you to once again explore different areas. Now, I've got to say, I just absolutely love the Coruscant scenery. Coruscant is one of my favorite planets, especially from the prequels and Attack of the Clones, when they're kind of jumping on speeders and stuff. And this just really gives me that vibe. So I've got to say, I'm getting a little bit nostalgic just running around here. But aside from scenery, once again, cool area to just run around in. But I've got to say, one of the most unique ways to use this method is actually on the Manaan Stronghold. And I made a video about this a while back when the Stronghold was first released. But you can actually use the logout method to go swimming under the water. So this allows you to access basically lower areas of the Stronghold. This is one of the most glitchiest parts, because this is obviously not an area you're supposed to kind of roam around in. But you can kind of go underneath the Stronghold, roam throughout these different buildings. If you keep going straight, however, you kind of glitch out and you fall underneath. And it used to be that you would actually be able to explore the depths. But unfortunately, I think they got patched or something. And now it becomes an exhaustion zone, which means you are forcibly exited out. Which is really unfortunate. It used to be a really cool kind of thing you could do. The logout method is one method. This also works as kind of like a war zone thing. So if you queue for a war zone and then get a pop, if you do the same thing, you kind of jump off a balcony or something, enter the war zone and then exit the war zone, it has the same effect. But the war zone pop method could also be used to access even deeper in Manaan. You could see like the Fraction Shark and a whole bunch of these other things close up, but unfortunately that has been removed. Nonetheless, still pretty cool to kind of just run around underneath the Manaan Stronghold. And that kind of ends what I've been able to figure out for the Stronghold part of this. I've tried this on Nar Shaddaa, for example. It doesn't work, so it won't work everywhere, but I think there are some other cool things to be found. So if you guys have found anything, please let me know in the comment section, let other people know. I think it'll be really cool to figure out more ways in which we can explore the strongholds. But in any case, I also want to show you a few on the fleet as well, because the fleet is pretty cool. The first one is actually exploring the area of the fleet beyond the railing. So as you guys know, that big dark abyss that if you jump into, you will eventually die. Well, you can actually use the logout method to get underneath it and end up on the ground. You can kind of once again just run around there. Not much to do, but it's a cool area to just roam around on the fleet if you're waiting for like a war zone pop or something. I don't know. It's cool. It's unique. And it's private and empty. No one's here. No one knows about it. So it's kind of, it's your place where you can do your own thing. And I'd be really curious to see if people from the top above the railing could actually see you just running around down there. Now that would be cool, but unfortunately I don't have two accounts or anything to test it on, but maybe you could test it out with some of your friends and let me know. It'd be really cool if you could actually see the person just running around down there. And that would be actually pretty neat, and I think a lot more people would want to jump down here and actually do this. The next one is also on the fleet, and it's been in the game for a while now, and it's actually a way in which you can see what's outside of the fleet. So what you do is you kind of run to the middle area of the fleet, and this works both on Imperial and Republic, and you go to that cantina area, and then you go right into the crevice underneath the stairs. And what you'll do is just once you kind of go in, zoom fully in into your screen and kind of move around, try to get right into the crevice, and eventually you'll hit a spot where you can actually see outside of the fleet and see the whole space area. And it's really cool to think that BioWare has actually put effort into making something out there, because this, from what I know, this isn't really something you see in the game, or isn't meant to be seen, but it's there, and when you kind of glitch it out, you eventually see it, and you'll see planets, you'll see spaceships, you'll eventually see like those star cruisers actually go into hyperspace mode, and all this really cool stuff that you guys can go ahead and explore for yourselves. Definitely a very cool and unique type of scenery that you wouldn't normally see in the game, so I'm quite excited to show that off as well. And finally, I'll show you a cheeky little trick you can do with the Tatooine Stronghold to actually trigger a sandstorm in the Stronghold. And this effect is something that not only you can see, but everyone else can see and experience the same time as well. And so basically what you do is just on the Tatooine Stronghold, you get to the far edge of the downstairs level, and you just keep on running into the desert. Keep running into the distance, eventually you will die from it being an exhaustion zone, and then when you respawn, it will actually trigger a sandstorm. And the sand will kind of come and flood through the entire stronghold and just become misty and really hard to see, and the effect can actually last like 5 to 10 seconds. Once again, doesn't really serve a purpose, but I think it looks pretty damn neat, and especially if you had like a lot of people over in the stronghold and stuff, you could just kind of do it, and it's kind of cool. In any case, hope you guys enjoyed the video. That's all I've been able to figure out for now. If you have something really cool to share, I'd love to see it in the comment section below. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys in the next one.